First, 1 year after Hurricane Idalia almost split Dorsett Stadium in two, Taylor County takes the field against one of their biggest rivals. Could the upstart Bulldogs pull off the upset and take down Big Bad Wakulla? Welcome in to your football Friday night. High school football is a magical sport, Allison.
Yeah, and I think tonight, some of these highlights we have tonight, very excited to tell them about.
It absolutely is. And listen, we can't build up this story any further.
No.
So let's just go ahead, make sure we give everything the time it's due. Sydney Wicker is standing by Dorsett Stadium in Perry. Sid, War Eagles, Bulldogs, this one was an absolute classic.
A classic. You mentioned the magic, the electricity in here, unreal, one you had to be here to see. We're not going to waste any more time, though. Let's go ahead and jump right into the action that had everyone on their seats until the fourth quarter. Quarterback Owen Cleese tosses this one to Jordan Barnes on the edge. He'll hurdle a guy and pick up the first down. Just a few plays later, they hand this one off to Sion Ranson, who heads straight up the middle and into the end zone. Wakulla strikes first and leads 7-0. That score would hold into the second quarter. Mistakes, though, would hurt the Bulldogs early, but they find a new spark here in the second quarter. They hand this one off to DJ McCoy, who comes straight through and takes off running. He's brought down near the 40-yard line. It's almost like watching a replay, except this time they're going for six. Another handoff to DJ McCoy. Taylor County gets on the board. More magic to come from the offense as Hamilton throws this ball wide to Kingston Williams, who scores, and just like that, it's 13-7 Bulldogs. Wakulla would struggle, but they'd eventually add on six, so we'd head into the half with the War Eagles leading 14-13. A back-and-forth battle would only heat up. This game would be tied 20-20 all heading into the fourth quarter. Taylor County is able to take the lead, all thanks to a special teams return. Wakulla would threaten to take this game into overtime with seconds left on the clock. An absolute thriller for the second week in a row for Taylor County. It's fourth down, and that Bulldog defense shuts everything down. Taylor County will beat Wakulla for the first time in 14 years. That final score, 27-20, and head coach Jesse Braswell left speechless after this one.
I'm pretty much never lost for words, but our kids deserve that, man. They just, it's not about me. It's about our program and our kids. They have literally, since the first day I got here, have done nothing but do what I ask them to do. And when that happens and you buy into a vision, you see results. And we got a lot to clean up now. But man, it feels good to win at home.
Now, the last time the Bulldogs beat Wakulla, it was actually Coach Braswell, who was on that senior class in 2010. And after the game, he sat right here at this goalpost and soaked it all in as everybody emptied out of the stadium. To say it was magic, I don't even know if that does it enough justice. A true storybook ending out here for Taylor County. Back to you guys.
I legit have chills.
I'm trying hard
to
keep this
legit
together.
Have chills. I was in Taylor County after Idalia. And then this past year after Debbie, I mean, to see Dorsett Stadium, and you mentioned it, torn in half. I mean, the press box was gone last year. They rebuilt the baseball fence this year, torn down again in Debbie. That community has been through so much over the last year.
Even beyond the hurricane.
Coach Braswell came back to his hometown to coach this team. So incredibly excited for him, for this community. If anybody deserves a win tonight, it is Coach Braswell and the Taylor County Bulldogs.
Listen, Perry, have a good time tonight, y'all.
Yeah, celebrate, guys. Take it all in.
Deserve it. Hey,